Assalamualaikum. The name of our project is IoT-based substation monitoring and controlling with security system. Our project is divided into three parts. They are security part, safety part, monitoring and controlling part. This security part is divided into two parts. One is the RFID tag system and other is the password system. The person from the management who will enter the substation will enter using the RFID tag. The door will open when the place the RFID tag on the reader. And the door will close when he put the RFID tag on the reader again when he exit. The RFID tag should be placed in a place that can be used both inside and outside. Also, if for some reason our RFID tag is broken or damaged or lost, then we will use the second method, that is the password method. When we use this password method, we first need to disable the RFID that is enabled. To disable RFID, we first go to the password mode. First, we have to enter *. Then there will be RFID matched with 55, 33, 11. After that, we can see that our RFID has become disabled. Now we will give hash to go into password mode. Then we will give the password that we have given in the programming, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. See the door open as soon as the code is given. Thus, when I lock the door again, I will go back to security mode and give the password 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. See the door is closed again. The person is search will use RFID and security in this way. Then when we disable it, we will give 55, 33, 11 with *, again, and it will be enabled immediately. In this case, we can use RFID tag again. This is how our security part will work. Then there is our second part, is safe. Safety part. We have used two devices for the safety part. They are gas sensor and temperature sensor. So we are using gas light to measure the temperature and the presence of gas here. When we hold the gas light near the gas sensor, the presence of gas is 98%. And when we hold gas light near the temperature sensor, the temperature is show the value of 28 degrees Celsius. We will see the same value on the IoT server. The smoke is 98% and the temperature is 28 degrees Celsius. So in this way, this circuit works. Now we will discuss next part. At this stage, we will describe the third part of the project. This part includes the load monitoring and controlling part. This is an important and key part of the project. In this system, we have used Wi-Fi module for monitoring and controlling. We need to turn on a hotspot to run this Wi-Fi module. This allows us to send the data to the server. Here it is our server. We tell you have to work it. We can also use router instead of mobile hotspot here. Basically, the substation has to be covered by a network. Now we are offloading to see the load in our display. We see that there are 201 volt, 0.01 ampere and 0 watt. We'll also look at the server. The server show ST voltage 201 volt, ST current 0.01 ampere and watt 0. I can also see the same LT load. When we look at ST and LT load, we also look at temperature and smoke at the same time. Now we will see what value is displayed on the display after loading and whether the value is changing at the same time on the server. This is what we will monitor. Now we will turn on the load. The ST load will turn on within 15 seconds of switching. Now our ST load is turned on. Let me say one thing here. This is the ST load of our substation. Here I will control the LT load under ST load. I will run the LT load while keeping the ST load on. If we turn off the ST load, the while system will be turned off. One thing to keep in mind is that you have to control the LT load while keeping the ST load on. Now we will turn on the alternate load, LT load 1. Our LT load 1 is turned on. Simultaneously, we are displaying values on the server. If we refresh, we can see our watt and ampere. Here we can see on the display 201 volt current 0.02 amperes and watt 40 watts. In this case, I can see ST 120 volt 0.2 amps and 40 watts on the server. Similarly, in LT, we can see 0.42 amperes. Now I am turning on the next load, that is load 2 has been started. On the server I press see load 2 is started. Load 3 is turned on. Now I am switching load 4. Sequentially, all loads are turned on. We use total 4 LT load and 1 ST load. All loads are on. In this case, we will look at the server. This server show at a total of 198 volts, 1.17 amperes and 293 watts. That voltage we see in ST in 205 volts and 0.94 amperes and 193 watts. The voltage in our LT is 239 volt and the current is 1.17 ampere and the watt is 193. We see that the display of our project and the value of the server match perfectly. In fact, the main purpose of our project is to monitor and control the substation of any angle, which we can do through our project. we can monitor the current voltage and watt. At the same time, we are able to control the project from any angle, whether it is from mobile or computer. We can do it from any part of the world. Now we will see that if we load OST, our whole system will be turned off. So we loaded off OST, our whole system is off. Now all our value have changed. Now the voltage of our grid is 201 volt, 0.5 amperes and 0 watt. There is a little refresh here, as it takes 15 to 20 seconds to show the value of server. Now we can see that the display and the value of the server are showing the same. We can say in this situation that our project has been successful. Thanks for visiting our project.